Thanks to decades of concerted international action and the unequivocal success of the Montreal Protocol in controlling ozone depletion, up to 2 million cases of skin cancer may be prevented each year. When nations of the world adopted the Montreal Protocol on substances that deplete the ozone layer and agreed to stop using harmful chemicals, only few people believed that their concerted efforts to protect our health and that of the environment, including wildlife and agriculture, would have yielded so many benefits in just a few decades. Every year, International Ozone Day reminds us of what we can achieve through unity of purpose and provides us with renewed impetus and confidence that through committed global partnerships, we can achieve our goals, however ambitious. Scientific evidence today shows that the ozone layer is on track to recovery, but our job under the Montreal Protocol is far from complete. Our mission is yet to be accomplished. We still have 640 metric tons of ozone depleting chemicals that need to be phased out. Indeed, we need to manage the banks of these substances that remain in equipment, building walls, and chemical stockpiles. And our job doesn't stop there. Relatively small, these remaining uses are currently exempted for reasons of essentiality and criticality to society and still need to be phased out. I would like to remind all of us of an often overlooked achievement of the Montreal Protocol, which has been its contribution to mitigating climate change through the phasing out of ozone-depleting substances. Had we not acted back in 1987, the world would now be suffering even more climate change impacts, including severe droughts, floods, and storms. The state of the world's climate calls for bolder and swifter action to lay a stronger foundation for our healthier future. On the occasion of International Ozone Day, I commend all the 197 contracting parties that have made the Vienna Convention for the Protection of the Ozone Layer and the Montreal Protocol such an outstanding example of international cooperation and a model for united action to further tackle many global challenges. In 2015, we will celebrate the 30th anniversary of the Vienna Convention. We need to redouble our current efforts to reap even more health benefits and to avert further damage to crops, wildlife, and the materials that we use daily. Remember, protecting the ozone layer is protecting ourselves.